And this is how to draw an old school butterfly. Enjoy.
How to draw an old school butterfly. That's going to be very traditional. We're going to be doing this on the iPad Pro in Procreate. But you can do this on normal paper with pens, markers, paints, whatever you want. Just copy what I do and make slight adjustments to suit the medium. So first off, because it's going to be sort of nice symmetric, we're going to turn on a symmetry tool. So we just draw both sides at the same time. Just speed things up. So click on the settings, put on drawing guide, click edit drawing guide, and just make sure symmetry is highlighted at the bottom. And click done. And just on here, now you're going to have like four different layers. So you've got line work, sketching, shading, colour. We're going to start with sketching, then line work, then shading, then colour. Just make sure they're all got assist on. So click on it and click draw an assist. This just makes it so each one has got the symmetry on, so it draws both sides. Like I said, it just speeds up everything. So on your sketching tool, we're going to select sketching, technical pen, and we're going to select a dark red just to sketch out stuff. So I'm going to start off with, just draw yourself a circle, like so. Draw a second kind of circle shape and just come to a point at the end. So start off circular, come to a point. And the little circle here, just sitting above, just so it kind of cuts into this circle. So you want it to kind of cut into that oval shape. Just above it, bring out a curved line, come outwards, and bring that line back, going a little bit wider, and come back to the point you started. Just like so. Now starting at this kind of point, just here, we're going to create the wings. So we're going to bring this up and nice and outwards. I'm going to curve this inwards. Curve down. And curve back. Now I like to try and make sure that these lines don't kind of, you know, the edges don't fall on the same kind of line. So I'm going to make this circle a little bit shorter and just make sure these edges are a little bit lower. I just feel like if things are in line, it just doesn't quite look right. So we're going to bring the second wing now. So we're going to go curve, curve, and then bring this up here. So we're not going to touch this bottom part of the body. We're going to curve around that, like so. Now, let's make it a bit more curvy. Now we're going to bring a secondary line just here, just mimicking the outside line, like that. And same with the bottom, just mimicking the outside line. And the inside bit here, I'm going to create a curve, coming up to the top, a secondary line just on the inside of it. I'm going to do again, just smaller version, just above, just there. And then I'm going to bring out one, two, three, four lines. This bottom bit, we're going to create a curve here, do a circle on the inside, and go one, two, three, three lines. So this is it for the basic outline. So we're now going to go into line work. We're going to select black. I'm going to go inking, and you can use your own, whichever one you prefer. I'm going to use studio pen, and I've got it slightly adjusted so it draws a straight line. So it's like nice even thickness. And we're going to quite bold with this, you know, I want it to be nice and bold. Zoom in. So yeah, we're going to go over everything we've just done now with black ink. Now in Procreate, if you draw and hold it, it kind of sort of straightens out your lines. I know you can't do it on paper, but it's a handy tool on thingy. If you've done on paper, just be careful and just draw it nice and neat. If you don't want to do that, speed is your friend on Procreate. Like here, if you draw this line slowly, sometimes it might not be perfect, it might be a bit uneven. But if you draw a nice and quick line, bosh. Straight in there. Bosh. God, I'll never say that. And you can turn on the Procreate as well, so you get different angles. You'll often find some angles a bit more comfortable than others, so don't be afraid to sort of change your angle if you need to. Same on paper, you can always pick the paper up, turn it around. You know, personally, I find that my lines this way is a lot more comfortable to do it in the opposite way. So I'll very often sort of turn my paper around. So join those lines. Butterflies are always really fun designs for tattoos. You know, it's one of those ones that work with a lot of things, so can always be added. Or just on their own, they look really cool. And People can say they want her, not just for girls. I tattoo a lot of butterflies on guys. Little line there just on the inside bit, and I'm going to do a few little detail bits here. So I'm going to bring in a line just here, circle, straight line, two ones, two little circles there. Just kind of a few little pattern bits just here and there. So I'm going to put in some black dots just going around this part, just keeping about even distance apart. You know, you can make them wider or shorter if you want. I think that'd do for, one line we forgot. There we go. That'd do for the outline. Now turn off the sketching, so you've got just your line work left. And now click on the shading. And up here in the top left-hand corner, you've got your selection tool. Click that, and down the bottom, you can see it's got automatic. Make sure automatic is selected. Now when you select it, the bit of blue is going to draw just in those areas. So we're going to select these ones, and those ones to begin with. Now I'm going to select airbrushing, large soft airbrush. And I'm going to put some pitch black coming down there. I think my colour that bit in solid black. I'm going to select these three areas. I'm going to put a little bit of black just on the inside part, just around that body shape. Same on these little bits now, just there. Just so we've got a bit of black kind of fading out around the body. These bottom sections here. Black around those edges. And just a little bit of black just on the top corner of that bit. And lastly, I think I'm going to do a little bit just on the top there. And that'll do it for the blacks, I think. Actually, no, just one last thing. I'm going to colour in these with black. I like quite a lot of black in my butterflies. I think it looks good. So now I'm going to go to colour. So I'm going to select here, 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 and that, and those ones. And I want all those bits. I'm going to colour in red. So I'm just going to select red. Just draw over those. I'm going to select here, 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 and that, and I want these bits to be a caramel and yellow. So I'm going to go caramel to begin with, get like a nice bright yellow, go around the edges, like so. Now these bits, I'm going to have blue, so I'm going to select a nice blue, just dull it down a touch, I don't want it to be too strong. Just going to bold you in blue, then I'm going to select these top ones to begin with. I'm going to select my studio pen tool again, I'm going to make it quite thick, and I basically want to make this a bit darker now. Put some lines through the middle bits, just there, like so. And quite similar on the bottom now. There we go. Just turn off the drawing guide so it gets that line out of the way. And there you have it. That is how to draw an old school butterfly. I hope you like it. You can customize it, play around colors, you know, adjust them. I mean, click on the hue saturation if you want and just scroll through all my different kind of color combinations you could have. But yeah, I'm the Broken Puppet. Check out my videos, comment, like, subscribe, yada, yada, yada. And I'll see you next time. Peace.